Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to talk about Power BI release September 2022. If you're new to this channel, this series is all about updating Power BI releases, because if you're very new to Power BI as well, Power BI team releases every month some features about Power BI, or it can be bug fixes or any features, new releases. So we will talk about it, and also we will discuss anything that majorly released by Power BI. That is the prime focus of this playlist. With this note, let's begin. So this is about September 2022 futures summary. There are a lot of items that Power BI has released, and as usual, I like some of the parts. Like, one of the item is like hierarchical access, and another thing is about translations. The third one is all related to cross tenant. Other things are very minor, and we can discuss one by one. So coming to the first one, hierarchical access, I have made a separate video related to this. We need to do certain workarounds. Basically, what is the issue here is, like, when you have a hierarchical data in your x-axis, by default you cannot have a x-axis hierarchy. So that is a problem we used to have earlier, but most of the people doesn't know this feature exists as well. So Power BI team has come up with a fix. Like, by default, when you drag multiple items in the x-axis, that is hierarchical data, by default it will create hierarchy for you, because this feature most of the people like it. So this is the one of the good thing they have done. And you have they have set behavior, what are the things before this release, after this release, like adding new fields to the x-axis field, well, and sort behavior. So we can go through this as well. Then coming to here, these are minor things, like when you drag and drop the columns, you have a sum and average of unit prices. By default it will appear, but recently, like for example, if you see here, they don't have the what is the aggregation of these two fields. This created confusion for the users. So they have now, you can see for the columns, you have a sum of what is the aggregations used. So then we can rename it. So this is the check or options you need to enable it for getting this options. Then conditional formatting for data labels. So you can see the data labels in the charts can be aligned to some more conditional formats as well. And as I said, the second exciting feature I like is like translations support for composite models. And if you are not aware what is translations, most of the reports are in English, and if people wants to see it in other languages like Arabic or Chinese characters, then they can enable the translations and provide for each item, like for say for each column, what is the Arabic equivalent translation for it. Then people can analyze on their own language. That is the main purpose of translations. So that is supported by composite models in this release. So other things you can go through here, like these are simple things like information protection and mobile formatting options. Let's move on to another exciting feature, like cross-tenant dataset sharing. So here, what is the beautiful feature over here is, like, the data set whatever we publish in Power BI services, which cannot be shared to other tenants till now, and this feature, I mean in this release, we can share the data set to other tenants, and they can build on top of that data set, shared data set, they can build their own data to merge between these two data sets, and they can publish it. So this is very interesting feature, and it is very challenging for till now. So this feature will open wide options for us to explore. So this is one thing, and they have mentioned what are the sequence of steps to be followed to enable the cross-tenant data sets. This is one thing, and I hope this feature already existing, auto-generate reports on existing dataset. So you have a dataset and you don't know what to build, right? Most of the times it will happen. So you can right click on it and then you can see auto create a report. So Power BI services, it will create a report for you if you don't know what to create. And so it will go through all the columns and whichever is considered as measures and whatever considers a categorical value, it will create a report for you. And obviously you no need to accept whatever Power BI generates. You are going to alter based on your needs. That will give you an initial template to kickstart. You can alter on your own test. That is another thing. Then other features, as you can see, like some of the features that most of the people's not aware, like embedded analytics. These are very niche concepts because very few big organizations use it. We will skip for it. And one more feature I like in the reporting is like this drill down combo chart, which is a multiple chart types. You can see usually we have column and line chart or two combination charts, right? Here you have a column, line and area chart. This feature, you can accommodate multiple measures and different dimensionality you can analyze in a single chart so that your space is saved. You can have a different analytics, like the same measure you are analyzing in different dimensions, which will give you more insights into it. So that's it about today. Whatever, I like it. I hope I can see you in another video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.